Great Scott.
Great Scott.
Great Scott.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another fabulous, fabulous, fabulous edition of Great Scott. You're not going to guess what happened. I traveled into the future, the far reaches of the future, and I have come back with an exclusive that only I could get from the scientists at Star Labs. They were searching the heavens, trying to find anything they could find on our Man of Steel, and what they did on June 14th, 2013, they held a press conference on what they found. They found clips, audio clips from different sources. Apparently there were different cameras in different areas. People were trying to hide what they were doing because apparently they were doing things that were against what some council in space had told them they were allowed to do. And so they've got some grainy footage. They've got some audio. They've got some things that they've worked out that they're going to show. Well, I'm going to show to you now because I went to the future for you, because I know that at no time would you ever call me a hack. At no time would you ever call me a no-talent person who couldn't take over for someone in a paper bag. At no time would you ever say I was boring or when I got into something a little personal, like on my first show and I tried to tell you a little bit about myself. At no time would anyone ever say that we don't care that you're a nerd. We don't care that your wife's a nerd. We don't care that you like Superman. We want to hear your opinions on stuff. And so, because I know that none of you would ever say those kinds of things to me, I have decided to share this with you. My friend, Professor Emil Hamilton, was able to translate this. It was all in Kryptonese, he tells me, a Kryptonian language. So, you know, Superman's from Krypton. You guys probably don't know Hamilton, but he's a good friend of mine, and he and his friends at Star Labs translated this, and the voices that you hear, and the dialect that you hear, and some of the accents that you hear are their computerized idea of what they think Kryptonians may have sounded like, and it's going to blow your mind. So let's take a look. Please don't ignore me. You must heed my warnings.
We have heard all these things before, Jor-El.
We must ready the pod. When I told you before, it was a warning of things to come. It is upon us now.
Your sound rantings, Jor-El, will do nothing but to salvage your reputation.
Lara, are we ready?
You need to keep silent. You must learn from your past mistakes.
Legacy of Krypton will live on. Lara, there isn't time. There's no more time.
You must calm down, Jor-El. Everything will be fine. You're overreacting.
Please, you have to tell that someone must listen to me, please.
The council is losing patience, please.
It's over for the rest of the day. We need power.
Hold, Jor-El.
Atomic batteries are powered.
Turbines are at speed.
Everyone on this couch
will listen to anything further you have to say.
And save them all.
Where, out in the darkness, is babe Kal-El sorry, cruising through space, hurling through space. Peace, let it save him. It broke me to yield. It's not safe in this place. It's not safe in this place. He'll find his way in the dark. He'll hold the course and keep aim. And those who fond him when he reaches landfall will give him new name. And when he falls to the planet Earth, his life will change. Stars in many colors shine over planets, teeming with light, glowing so bright, ironically waiting, ready to burst when they reach their last night. Rao has reached its last night. Now imploding above, it shall engulf us below. And those who have doubted my efforts will sadly soon know And though we'll fall through fury and die, Kal-El survives. He will grow in strength, for so I have studied, by the yellow star above the earth, that those from Krypton will learn to soar above the clouds. May good people find him, and may they keep him safe in their arms. May Kal-El be blessed till then, as he soars through the stars.
Well, my mind is officially blown. I've already watched it once or twice. I'm going to watch it again and again and again because I cannot believe the raw emotion. I cannot believe in this grainy footage that we found that this apparently Superman's father, Kal-El's father, Jor-El, singing to his son, hoping that one day he would be found by someone great on Earth that would help him, that would love him, that would hold him, that would protect him. And that we were able to find it, and that he was able to keep it hidden and keep it and send it off and decrypt it in encrypted files through space, bouncing off space stations and satellites, so that the people, the men and women, the geniuses at Star Labs were able to decode it and give it to me and you. But keep this to yourselves. Keep this to yourselves. It's not supposed to come out until June 14, 2013. So keep it to yourselves. Because we're friends here, and I know nobody would ever call me names or dislike what I do, and I know you all love it, and you're fans, and everything's great, so keep it to yourselves, and we'll share it together. We'll watch it as many times as we want. It's a fantastic thing. Oh, I got another little thing for you. Initially, when Hamilton and his friends decoded this transmission, what they had thought was that the person's name singing was like Javert or Russell or something along those lines, but those are off. They say that it's possible that those two names are somewhere in the multiverse, out there in another universe, in an alternate Earth, in Earth 2 or something along those lines. Who the hell knows what that means, but they say now that for sure Jor-El is what it translates to. It's in the footage, and as I said, the accents and the voices that you hear is all their interpretation, but they believe that they have the Kryptonian language translated perfectly, so everything that you hear, all the words that are said, everything that you see in the video is translated to English from Kryptonese, and it should be correct. So, Happy New Year, and holy mackerel, what a gift for 2013. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great, great new year, and remember, always look up in the sky.